Hello everyone, I'm Maren Kuchenbrot.
I'm Juliane Eberhardt.
I'm Ilya Anufriev.
And we are trying to tell you a little bit about what to expect from PhD life. I've been in the Schubert group in Jena now for almost 3 years.
And I'm here just, I guess it's 1 year, maybe 1 year and something.
And for me, it's the first week as a PhD.
So you really get the whole impact. How was, is your first impression right now?
Everything changed. So from master thesis, it's quite different. I have to look for many more things, for more general things, not only the chemistry part, also different stuff.
That can be quite a lot in the beginning. I think that's what we both experienced.
Well, in my case, it's even bigger change because I came from other country, I came from Russia, and now it's totally different how people are thinking, how people are working, but still it's kind of cool experience to give a try in other place, and it's nice that we can do it here. And for you, Maren?
I also did not study in Jena, so it's also a new city, but of course still the same language more or less. I think in the beginning it was very, very stressful with the whole getting to know people, who do you talk to if you want to do this or that experience.
That's the good point, because I studied in Jena before, and so I know a lot of the people, so, and I learned before a bit for which reason I have to go to which person. So this is fine, but there are still a lot of complicated things to learn.
If you're coming from Germany, be prepared for a lot of bureaucracy here. So,
but it's Germany. That's the whole essence of Germany.
I think it's one of the worst things of a PhD, the whole bureaucracy that you have to deal with.
But I think doing a PhD, it's even for us, it's a lot of work with different offices and trying to deal with financing or like writing reports or buying stuff, or you have to go through different processes and you really need to learn them in the beginning, and you don't realize that as a student. At least I did not realize it as much as a student. I think what you really get to see during a PhD is how the university works and how the structure works and all those different things, and I think that's really different from student life. But as we want to talk about researching, how do we start that?
Just to start my research, I guess I will just talk to my boss first, just what he expects and want to be discovered, and then I will just try, because I mean no one knows we're doing research, just because no one knows how it works, so we're like just try, and no one knows it better than you yourself. No one can tell you how to do this.
I think especially at the beginning it's a lot, because you have to read through all those research papers and try to evaluate what's really sensible and what's not sensible, I think.
Yeah, but thanks God this group are kind of really big. So I think at the end you can find someone to ask about your question. I mean,
yeah, sure, but I mean it's still
people.
Your topic.
Okay.
I mean, I don't know anything about not anything. I don't know that much about
ultracentrifuge
apart from what you tell.
So for this we have a big group seminars every week, so we can know each our project better. But
you can ask other people for how a machine is working or how you get your analytical data. Also, but how your chemistry is working, you cannot ask, because
it's your chemistry.
They don't know.
I don't know, I'm not a chemist, I'm a physicist, so.
So you don't care
nothing.
About chemistry?
I care about chemistry.
Very good.
But it's cool.
I think that's really fascinating about this work group, or also PolyTarget in this area, because you get to talk to a lot of people from different areas. So you get to talk to physicists, you get to talk to chemists, you get to talk to material scientists. And everyone has a little bit different point of view on problems, I think. That's also quite helpful a lot of times.
Yep, that's true.
So you can look forward to that.
Yeah, for me the new thing is to just talk with biologists or medicinists, so that I have to learn a lot of new things in this direction, and not only like in all my studies before, just to have the focus on chemistry.
Yeah, and I think also the difference from coming from student life.
You said it like now we are adults, like
25
years old, like, oof, yes, in our
And I mean, we're still learning, obviously.
Yes.
But I think there's still a difference between student and PhD student, because as a student, you always have one person that also is in charge of your project, more or less. So you can always go to him and ask him things. And now, of course, you have a supervisor, but it's still, it's more your own project, it's more your own research.
Yeah.
It's a different attitude towards some questions, I guess, at least that's how I feel.
Yeah.
The feeling that when I do research, of course, there's a lot of things that fail. There are also obviously a lot of mistakes you do, experiments that fail. But I think what I see from the cell, that when something fails, I'm not like, it doesn't work, but I try to think about new angles, and I don't think I had that before, not that much. So now every time I go home, I was like, what? How can I tackle that?
Not chemistry, just analytical stuff. If something failed, you just try it once again with the different conditions, and that's it. So it's less, let's say...
Yeah, but you have different conditions, so you have to think about which condition would make sense, right?
Yeah, well, I mean, it's not like in the chemistry, like, oh, if I add this thing, or if I do it like that, or if I do this reaction, if I do that, I don't know about what I'm thinking about now, so sorry if I've done something wrong. But I think it's more freedom in chemistry than in just analytical stuff.
I needed to learn to not take those failure personal. So because in the beginning you're struggling with yourself, with your confidence, and if you're not a good chemist, when your experiments don't work and so on, and I needed to learn that often it's just not working, and that you just have to continue to find a solution, and that it's not your fault that it's not working.
Yes.
Yeah, I think that's...
Sometimes you just...
That's a good insight.
Sometimes you just have to stop, go for coffee or beer, then next day continue.
Yeah. I mean, of course, that process is a little bit stressful, but I think you also learn a lot during that. Like, as you said, like, learn that it's not your fault. Most of the times it's not your fault.
Hopefully.
But yeah, I think. And that's where you have to go on and see new stuff. I think that were my 5 points. Do you have anything else?
Yeah.
If you have new aspects.
I think something completely different from a master to PhD is that you need to present a lot more, so that you're just, it's not only about your research. It's not only about your research, it's also about presenting what you did and what you found out, and that's what you have in master, for example, really in the end for your defense, but here you have later like conferences and like meetings with other people where you need to show what you did and where you have to present yourself and to defend your work.
Yeah, that's true.
But
and
I
you also mean you want to write a publication in the end, so you need to phrase it in a way, or like try to think about what other potential peer reviews might think about your work, so you have to tackle those issues.
What about you, Mari, the oldest PhD from us?
Thanks so much. I really think what you said is true, and I think it's also like going through this process, like presenting it again and again during seminar or conference, or also writing a publication, I think you also get a different view about publications from other people's. So because you just know your topic better and you know how things might be phrased, you can see and evaluate other reports better than you could before, probably.
What is this video in your
YouTube channel? If you want to know more about...
Subscribe to this YouTube channel.
Right, and also there are a lot more videos on this channel, so you can watch those or go on one of the other social media platforms to get more information. Mm.